Dear students, now we are going to discuss TEM waves in rectangular waveguide and derive its field equations. TEM means transverse magnetic. TEM waves are the waves in which the magnetic field is entirely transverse along the direction of propagation. Here we consider the direction of propagation as Z1. So here HZ becomes 0. Then the TEM wave has an electric field strength in the direction of propagation that is not equal to 0. You will understand this one. For TEM waves, that EZ value is not equal to 0, but HZ is equal to 0. Next, we are going to find out the field components of the TEM waves. It can be determined by using the electromagnetic wave equations. For this TEM waves, we have to consider the wave equation in terms of electric field, because it has only the electric field in the direction of propagation. So del squared Ez is equal to minus omega squared mu epsilon Ez. That is the wave equation in terms of electric field. As we all know that del squared means what? Dou squared by dou x squared, dou squared by dou y squared, dou squared by dou Ez squared. Okay, so this is the wave equation in terms of electric field in the direction of propagation. Okay, so here as we all know that the derivative of this Ez in the direction of Ez is represented with its propagation loss. So here this term can be represented as gamma squared Ez. Then this wave equation can be written like this. Dou squared Ez by dou x squared plus dou squared Ez by dou y squared plus gamma squared Ez is equal to minus omega squared mu epsilon Ez. Consider this as the first equation. Okay, so here we are using the term dou because this Ex has the components of x as well as y. So in order to make it as a differential one, we have to use the term x and y. Here this capital X represents the function of x component. Capital Y represents the function of Y component alone. So here E Z naught, that is the amplitude of this electric field in Z direction, is equal to X into Y. Do you all understand this one? We are going to substitute this value in this first equation. Then this partial differentiation becomes normal differentiation. Okay. Then the wave equation becomes D squared XY by DX squared plus D squared XY by DY squared plus gamma squared xy is equal to minus omega squared mu epsilon xy. So all the EEZ term can be replaced with the value x into y, correct? So whenever we are going to differentiate with respect to this x component, this y is a constant. We can take it outside. So y into d squared x by dx squared plus x into d squared y by dy squared plus gamma squared xy. We can move this term to this side, okay? Then this term becomes plus omega squared mu epsilon xy is equal to 0. Okay, for further simplification, we can take this xy as a common term from this one. Then we can get the value as xy into gamma squared plus omega squared mu epsilon. As we all know that gamma squared plus omega squared mu epsilon is nothing but h squared. Then this equation can be written like this. Y into d squared x by dx squared plus x into d squared y by dy squared plus h squared xy is equal to 0. Here each term is having both x and y components. Okay, for further simplification, we are going to divide each term by the value xy. Then we can get the value as 1 by x d squared x by dx squared plus 1 by y d squared y by dy squared plus h squared is equal to 0. So now we do have only the x term, y term and the constant term, all are equal to 0. Then we have to move this y component to this side as a minus. From this we come to know that this equation equates the function of x components and the function of y components. We can consider the function of x component and the function of y components is equal to a squared. A squared is a constant. Then this equation can be written like this. 1 by x d squared x by dx squared plus h squared is equal to minus 1 by y d squared y by dy squared is equal to a squared. Consider this as the second equation. Next, we are going to find out the values of x and y. For that, we can consider the x term alone from the second equation. 1 by x, d squared x by dx squared plus h squared is equal to a squared. Move this a squared to this side as a minus. Then we can consider this h squared minus a squared as a b squared. This equation can be written like this, 1 by x, d squared x by dx squared plus b squared is equal to 0. For further simplification, we can take this 1 by x as a common one and move the term to this right hand side. Then this equation can be written like this, d squared x by dx squared plus b squared x is equal to 0. As we all know that the solution for this equation is given like this, capital X is equal to C1 cos BX plus C2 sin BX. Okay, so this is the value of the X component. Similarly, we can get the value of Y component. So for that, we can consider the Y components alone. Minus 1 by Y d squared Y by dy squared is equal to A squared. Then we can take this value to this side as a plus. Then we can get 1 by Y d squared Y by dy squared plus A squared is equal to 0. Then we can take this 1 by y as a common term from this side and move that value to this right hand side. This side it becomes 0. Here we can get d squared y by dy squared plus a squared y is equal to 0. So here the solution for the second order quadratic equation is y is equal to c3 cos ay plus c4 sin ay. Okay, so now we have obtained x and y components. Then we are going to substitute these two values in the EZ0 term. So what is EZ0? It is nothing but the product of X and Y. We can simply substitute those values here. C1 cos BX plus C2 sin BX multiplied with C3 cos AY plus C4 sin AY. We are going to multiply all the terms together to get the value of this EZ. Okay, this is very very important factor in this TM wave. Okay. Then the E is a component can be written like this, C1 C3 cos BX cos AY plus C1 C4 cos BX sin AY plus C2 C3 sin BX cos AY plus C2 C4 sin BX sin AY. Consider this as the third equation. This is the general solution of the E is a component for TM waves. This is very very important equation. So next we are going to find out the values of C1, C2, C3 and C4. For that we can use boundary condition. So at this boundary values, this EZ term becomes 0. So here EZ is equal to 0, at X is equal to 0, X is equal to A, Y is equal to 0, Y is equal to B. First we are going to use this first boundary condition, EZ is equal to 0, at X is equal to 0. So in this condition, this third equation, okay, so this third equation becomes C1, C3 cos 0 because EZ becomes 0 at X is equal to 0, correct? So BX is 0 here plus C1, C4 cos 0 sin AY plus C2, C3 sin 0 cos AY plus C2, C4 sin 0 sin AY is equal to 0. Okay, as we all know that cos 0 value is 1. So here we can get the value as C1, C3 cos AY, C1, C4 sin AY, sin 0 value becomes 0. Here it is also 0. Now we have obtained C1, C3 cos AY plus C1, C4 sin AY is equal to 0. So here we have to take any one of the constants to make it as a 0, 1. So whichever constant becomes 0 here, whenever C1 is equal to 0, both the term becomes 0. The condition is satisfied. So we can consider C1 is equal to 0. If you are going to choose C3 is equal to 0 means this term alone becomes 0. Correct? If C4 is equal to 0 means this term becomes 0, not this one. So we have to select the common one, C1 is equal to 0. After getting this value, we are going to substitute this C1 is equal to 0 in the third equation. Then the third equation becomes EZ0 is equal to C2 C3 sin BX cos AY plus C2 C4 sin BX sin AY. Consider this as the fourth equation. Now the general solution is reduced because of that value C1 is equal to 0. Correct? So next we are going to use the second boundary condition EZ is equal to 0 at Y is equal to 0. Then this fourth equation can be written like this. EZ value is equal to 0 when y is equal to 0. So here we can take c2, c3, sin bx, cos ay. Cos ay means here y is equal to 0. Cos 0 is 1. Correct? So this term becomes c2, c4, sin bx, sin 0. Here y is equal to 0, right? So this term becomes 0. The entire term is 0. So now we have obtained c2, c3, sin bx is equal to 0. So now whichever constant becomes 0, if you are going to select c3 is equal to 0, here in this fourth equation, this term only becomes 0. If you are going to select c2 is equal to 0, both the term becomes 0 in this fourth equation. It is not possible, right? So here we can select c3 alone 0. We are going to substitute this value in this fourth equation to get the final answer. Then the simplified value EZ0 is equal to c2 c4 sin bx sin ay. Here c2 is not equal to 0, c4 is not equal to 0. Any one of these two constants becomes 0 means all the term becomes 0. As we all know that EZ should not be equal to 0. Correct? So here we can consider the constant value C is equal to c2 c4. Then we can write the equation or the field component of EZ as C sin BX sin AY. Consider this as the fifth equation. So in this one, we are going to find out A and B values. Okay. So in order to find out the values of A and B, we are going to use third and fourth boundary conditions. Here the third condition is EZ is equal to 0 at X is equal to A. Then we can write this fifth equation as C sin BA sin AY is equal to 0. We have to keep this sin BA alone this side, move all other terms to this right hand side as a denominator. 0 divided by anything becomes 0. Okay. Then we can keep sin term to this side as sin inverse 0. Sin inverse 0 means what? Its value is m into pi. M is an integer value. It can be 1, 2, 3, 4, any values. Okay. So sin m pi is always 0. So here we can mention BA is equal to m pi. Then B is equal to m pi by A. We have obtained the value of B. Okay. The same way we can find out the value of A using the fourth boundary condition. EZ is equal to 0 at Y is equal to B. Then the fifth equation becomes C sin BX sin AB is equal to 0. From this we can get sin AB is equal to 0 means sin AB is equal to sin inverse of 0. Here we can take another integer n into pi. Okay. From this A is equal to what? N pi by B. Where n is equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. Okay. So here we can substitute this A and B values in the fifth equation to get the field component of EZ in the TEM waves. So here EZ is equal to C into sin m pi by AX sin n pi by BY. This is the EZ component for TEM waves. Okay. Next we are going to find out the field components of TEM waves. So for that we can use EZ term in the general field equations of rectangular waveguide. We have already derived the general field components of rectangular waveguide in the previous lecture video. Correct? We can directly use this field equations here to get the TEM waves. Okay, so you have to remember this four field equations for rectangular waveguide. Here EX, EY, HX, HY, all in terms of HZ and EZ, correct? For TEM waves, as we know that HZ is equal to what? 0. Because the magnetic field is entirely transverse in the direction of propagation, it has only the EZ component. That's what we have derived, right? So EZ is equal to what? C into sin, what is the value here? Yes, it is BX sin AY. Okay, so B value is nothing but M by A. Here A value is nothing but N by B. This is what we have derived. We are going to use this EZ in this field equations to get the field components for TEM waves. Do you all understand this concept? So here for TEM waves, HZ is equal to 0, EZ is equal to C into sin BX sin AY. Here the propagation constant gamma represents only the imaginary term, that is phase constant. There is no attenuation. Okay, then the first equation. So this field equation Ex becomes, this Hz becomes 0. Then we can take the second value minus gamma by h squared. That gamma can be written like this, j beta dou by dou x of this Ez term. Wherever Ez comes, everywhere we can use this formula. Wherever Hz comes, all those terms become 0. So here the first equation can be written like this. Ex is equal to minus j beta by h squared dou by dou x. Here Ez value c sin bx sin ay. So we have to differentiate with respect to x. So here we can take this c as a constant outside. If you are going to differentiate with respect to this x, we can get the value as b into cos bx. Okay, then we can keep this sin ay as such. It is independent of this x value. X is equal to minus j beta c by h squared b cos bx sin ay. Similarly, we can get the value of Ey, that is equal to 0 minus gamma by h squared dou by dou y c sin bx sin ay. This gamma can be written like this, j beta. We can take this c outside with respect to y. So here we can take a sin bx cos ay. Next, hx is equal to j omega epsilon by h squared dou by dou y c sin bx sin ay minus 0. Then this term becomes j omega epsilon c by h squared. Here with respect to y, then we can get a sin bx cos ay. Finally, hy is equal to minus j omega epsilon by h squared dou by dou x of Ez value. Then we can get the value like this. So these all are the field components of TEM waves. Okay.